Hi Taurus, it's Power and Light Tarot coming at you with a reading. Today we're going to do your own reading, Taurus. And I have your oracle cards here like I always do, and right, and then I put the tarot cards down spontaneously. Yeah, I feel like for me that's it works for me, right? This is a really beautiful reading. At the heart of the matter, it really is the wishing well. Yes, it is. So I don't mean, you know, I'm wishing you well, Taurus. I really am wishing you well, right? Yeah, but I don't mean that, of course, right? I'm sure you guys know that. Just having fun here. But we also have love right here. This is Sappho, right? And it's right here with Mirabai and Devotion. And these cards have been shuffled. This kind of reminds me of the other day. I was doing a reading for Sagittarius, right? And they have been shuffled. And I feel like Sagittarius got these cards. And here's Sappho with her boobs hanging out, and she has her wings on, like she's going to, like, have some type of beautiful journey and fly away here and, you know, pull the rest of her dress off, right? Because here, if you guys can see her, she has some major cleavage here, right? And then, interesting, we have Devotion, and here's Mirabai with her see-through shirt and her her nipples showing, right? It's kind of an X-rated love here. Yeah, somebody has some major love, Devotion. And for me, there's some really good sex probably for some people. There probably is. We have transformation twice. Somebody could have been transformation showing up with the butterfly. But we also have Yumiko. And Yumiko wrote about, like role playing and like ghosts and people like kind of, she wrote about like masks and like flying phantoms and all this kind of stuff, right? But it can talk about role-playing, right? It can. This reading is about that card. Sorry, guys. It's about somebody role-playing. But they could be role-playing because they want a transformation sometimes, right? Maybe somebody was role-playing in the past. It could be because we have the snake right here, right, which talks about deception. I do believe, though, that somebody wants forgiveness here and that this has been transformed because we have let love be your beacon here. And that card talks about, like, let love be the deciding factor, right? Not what somebody did in the past, right? They could have stung you or whatever or bit you like a snake, Taurus, with their venom, left some venom in you, maybe, right? But, you know, somebody might think that somebody is their life purpose here. And because it's right next to the high honor card, this could talk about a career. Maybe you have found your life purpose, right? Could be. But this life purpose and the high honor with transformation, I feel like somebody kind of figured out that that you most likely, or you have figured this out, that somebody is like your life purpose, like especially in love, because we have love and devotion. Like you have somebody has figured out that somebody's like my twin flame, my soulmate. And this is like my life purpose to like live out my days with this person, it could be. And if, you know, if you're like 20, you could be thinking, well, I'm not thinking about that. Of course not, right? We never think of that stuff when we're young. We only start to think of it when we're older, right? And this is when we start to improve our ways because, you know, we're only going to be here for a while. Not just that, improve our ways in many different aspects. But we know that life is shorter now, so we want it to be more quality, right? Yeah, when you're young, you think you're going to live forever. You're like, wow, these days just keep passing by here, right? And the child is here. Somebody might have a child, of course. Yeah, right? This can talk about a new beginning, but usually it talks about a child. And we have the magnifying glass, so somebody is going, this could be you, going really deep about this. I feel like what you are, you could be wondering here, you could think somebody is your life purpose, like that's the person for me. and you could be wondering if you're going to have that wish with this person. Maybe they were deceptive to you in the past because of the snake. Maybe that's you being deceptive, Taurus, right? It could be, you know. But this creature's paw card talks about forgiveness and let love be, you can, right? Let love be your beacon. Like, she's holding the light, the lamp or the lantern. She's holding, like, some type of lantern. Looks like it's kind of shaped like a heart. But long story short, the butterflies are there. You know, she and here's the buddies, and they talk about fertility and abundance, right? But she is, like, receiving the light. She's letting love guide her, or love be the light, right? We know the light as information, or the way to go, or the understanding. Like, So, you know, this is let love be the deciding factor here, right? And we also have this card, Taurus, be your best self always. So maybe this was you, you know, role-playing as the snake. Because Yumiko is here, and she talks about somebody who could have been role-playing, because that's what she wrote about. She wrote about, like, these, like, role-playing, kind of like sci-fi and a little bit like horror, like role-playing. Like, I'm going to be a ghost today, and I'm going to be a flying phantom, things like that. And some of her work, they said, if you read it, it is, like, really shocking and kind of scary, right? Interesting, right? And this is be your best self always. Maybe somebody really wants to do that now. That's kind of what I'm getting in this reading. And I don't, this might not be you. This could be this person. So let's see what we have for Taurus. We're going to get a couple of shuffles in here. Mm-hmm. You know, we have a lot of moons here on this life purpose card. Maybe this, in the past, this was maybe a mystery kind of. Like somebody really didn't know. When the moon shows up, it can talk about things that are hidden or unknown, or maybe things that you can't really understand. So maybe it's possible here that somebody didn't understand that somebody else was kind of their life purpose, and that they have found out that they love somebody and that they are very devoted, right? And Mirabai ran away so she could kind of devote, like, her devotion was to herself, because she was being held down by her in-laws, right? She was like an artist and a musician. And I don't know the whole story on Mirabai. It's very interesting here. But they said she also kind of, she ran away. They tried to burn her. She didn't want to go along with them, right? She was in like an arranged marriage, I'm sure. But not to say they don't work out. That's a whole different, concept, in case anybody might get sensitive. But hers didn't, right? No. So she ran away. They tried to kill her, right? But she was devoted to herself. And I feel like they wanted her to be devoted to something she didn't want. Yeah, really interesting there. So let's see what we got here. And we have the Page of Cups for Taurus. Crossing you is the Magician. I want to get a couple more shuffles here on this deck because... just because... right. Let's see what we have for Taurus. Let's see what we have for Taurus. And we have the World card in the Root. So this could be a reconciliation with somebody, because we see the people embracing ever so tightly, right? You don't like hug somebody like that. And I mean, you know, it just looks like it's a reconciliation here. It could. But this is the end of a journey here. That's what this is about. I feel like you have come, you have the magnifying glass, right? This could be you or somebody else. I feel like you know somebody is the one, like your twin flame. You know that. You could be wondering if they are coming forward. It could be that simple. It could be. And I feel like you might have to give them forgiveness. Yeah, you might have to forgive them for something, some deception. Let's see what else we have. The King of Swords is in the recent past. Somebody took a decision in the past. This could be you or somebody else. Mm-hmm. And we have the Page of Wands and the Chariot card. And we have in your outcome is the Hierophant. So this could be you. This could be a marriage. Could be a commitment. Can talk about somebody's beliefs here. So we have one, two, we have three. We have four major arcana here, and then we have two court cards here. So this is already a great big reading, yeah. So let's see what we have, you guys. So here you are, the Page of Cups, the Magician. I feel like what you are doing, maybe you're contacting this person. I feel like what you are wondering here is that if this person possibly is going to come forward, you might have to ask for forgiveness. The reading could be switched. Maybe you were deceptive here. But the reading is clear in as much as this is about a transformation, a huge change from the past. I feel like somebody was role-playing. They could have been lying about their feelings, but there was role-playing and deception in the past. But somebody realizes here that somebody is like their life purpose and that they are devoted to somebody here. That they are devoted and that they really, really love somebody. And somebody is like somebody's real wish, like their true wish. But the magnifying glass is here. So somebody could have figured that out already. They could be studying the situation now. Mm-hmm. I feel like somebody now is being their best self. Like they have transformed. And I feel like in the past they were maybe even their worst self. I'm not sure here. This could be your person possibly. And we have the Magician and the Knight of Wands. Mm-hmm. And this is for Taurus, the King of Cups. Okay, and this can talk about somebody who's being offered a cup, but they don't see it. The king here doesn't see the cup being offered. You could be offering somebody something here, and maybe they don't see it. This could be in the past. They didn't see the offer. I feel like what this is in the past, somebody didn't see this for what it was, how beautiful it was. I feel like that's it. Yeah. And so now, maybe you are waiting for communication from this person, possibly. You could be wondering, for some, if they're going to come forward and make an apology, depending on who was deceptive here. But clearly, you want to manifest this, the Magician and the World card. And this World card, sometimes, you know, it talks about the end of a journey, a brand new world, a great achievement, a final fulfillment. But it can also talk about somebody who is ending a cycle to have a new cycle. It's possible this person had somebody in the past with the snake and the creature's paw. And this transformation, like role-playing. Somebody could have been kind of, you know, it could be, right? Let's get another card. Let's get a card on this World card. We have the Six of Cups. See, and I said that earlier. I thought I said that this was like a reconciliation. Because this is the Six of Cups. Somebody from the past. I did, because these people are hugging ever so tightly. And the King of Swords is in the past with the Eight of Swords. Wow, somebody took a decision, I feel like, to end another situation. Because we have the King of Swords grabbing the sword. Maybe it's an air sign, but it doesn't have to be. It could be this Pisces King. It could be a water sign. It could be anybody here, right? It could be a fire sign. We have the King of Wands here. And then we also have the King of Cups. We have the King of Swords here. It could be anybody here, right? But in the past, somebody took a decision to, like, end something. We see the Executioner. We have the King of Wands and the Seven of Pentacles. So this could be on your mind. You look like you are determined here, that you have the courage. But you could be wondering if somebody else is determined and they have the courage. Yeah, because that's what's on your mind. And that Seven of Pentacles is like... the sevens are always about analyzing, but this can be about somebody who is like determined. Maybe I feel like you're wondering if this person is determined, possibly, to come forward and have this. Yeah, it almost looks like you know somebody is coming here. It kind of looks like that. Yeah, but you could be maybe you could be using your intuition here all about this. You could. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you could. So let's see. In the near future, the Six of Pentacles is showing up. This can talk about like an investment sometimes. The Three of Swords. Yeah, somebody is going to take a risk, I believe, and kind of give to this or invest in this. We have the Three of Swords here, and the swords are coming out of the heart. They're either coming out of the heart. They could be going into the heart. This can talk about an ending, too. And that's what this World card can say. And then this Eight of Swords, Taurus, like... which is the Executioner. You could see the Executioner walking the woman out. He's got her blindfolded and he's going to shoot her. Possibly because, you know, this is what they want. Like, you know, if you don't want to do what they want, if you want to be a sovereign individual over your own body and make your own choices, that's really what they want. No comments on that one. Yeah, you could be saying that sounds majorly extreme. They would love to just tell you the truth about that. This is what we want. I'm not saying they're going to be able to do it. I'm saying they're doing this in other places. Very close to that. Very, very close. So we're not going to talk about that. No, we're not. Let's continue here, Taurus. Yeah. And let's see what we have here. Let's see what we have. Four of Swords. Yeah. See, this is a new beginning somebody's dreaming of here. The man's laying down. He's praying, right? He's praying, and this is a spiritual card about somebody's intuition as well. You know, The church is spiritual. It is. I mean, some people could be saying, oh, it's just organized religion. But the church can be spiritual in the fact that, you know, the prayers. They talk about the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. I mean, the Spirit, right? And so there is spirituality even in some organized religions. There is. That's a whole, like, talk show subject, right, that I'm sure you guys don't really want to talk about. But here he is. I feel like this is about intuition as well, even though he's in the church. This is my point. So he's praying, and he's asleep, like, or he's, you know, deep meditating, kind of, right? This is what I kind of mean about spirituality as well. And he's hoping his prayers are going to be answered. And here opens the window with all the butterflies fluttering in here. So this is about a new beginning, and this can be a recovery as well. I feel like you have only good things coming, Taurus, with this person. I feel like they might have hurt you in the past. These swords are coming out. And this person wants to, like, give to this. They want to invest in this. And what I mean, that sounds a little unromantic, but what I mean by that is somebody here, like, this could be you, of course, but it takes two, right? How could we can't just be you? But we're saying here that this person wants to give to this. Here's the Six of Pentacles. He's giving to these two people. But this person wants, like, they want to give to this and invest in this and, like, make an effort, right? We talk about investing, and it's not money. We talk about making an effort, right? Yeah, investing our heart and things like that and our time. We have the Knight of Cups. This is showing up in your concern. So you know, this Knight of Cups, Taurus, where the man hands the woman hands the man a cup. He's going to grab it. We see the King of Swords here. He's grabbing the sword. He doesn't have it yet. This is for a decision. This is to accept love, and this is in your concern. And you could be, like, wondering here, you're concerned here about getting to a better place with this person because of the deception in the past. You could also be, your concern is if they are maybe leaving another situation for some. Because sometimes this is a physical leaving, the Six of Swords. Sometimes it can be. And let's see what we have in your environment is the Page of Wands. This could be somebody who is kind of fiery, like very dynamic, or they're, it can be if it's a person, or their delivery is kind of like bam, wham, like, hey, what's up? And, you know, they're very direct. They don't, like, go around the corner. They just, you know, you understand what this person is about, like, kind of like a fire sign or a Sagittarian. They're just, they got their heart on their sleeves, and, you know, they just say it like it is, right? A lot of people can't handle that. No, they can't. And we have the Page of Wands and the Ace of Pentacles. This is in your environment. You have a new beginning coming. And I was saying that at the beginning of the reading. It just looks so beautiful. In this reading, Taurus, you might have to be on your best behavior. It could be. Or this person. Be your best self always, right? Here's the Seahorse. And here's the mermaid, and she's really beautiful. She's a mermaid, but she's able to get on the seahorse. So I don't know how they did that, how they split up her legs. Right? Because mermaids have, like, they have, like, two legs that are bound by the fin at the bottom, right? But I feel like here in your environment here, this could be a whole new direction. This Page of Wands can talk about a renewed interest sometimes, like a reconciliation. This is in your environment. This is a beautiful reading here. It is. This is happening for you. It is. Let's see what else we have. We have the Hanged Man. It looks like it's in the reverse. I'm going to take it the way I see it, the way it has fallen. It could have been in the upright, but that's okay. The Chariot card. This is your desire here. So you could be wanting somebody to take control of their life with this Chariot card. Here's the Olympian. I believe he's called an Olympian. I'm not sure. The Chariot is the vessel. I need to find out what his name is. I feel like I should. But maybe he is the Chariot. But long story short, this man's getting in the Chariot here, the vessel itself, and he's taking control of his life. He can't have movement or a victory without getting into the Chariot, right? You can't have your degree unless you go to college. You can't do this unless you, right, take action. So this is an action-oriented card. And this could talk about you wanting to overcome struggles with this person sometimes. It can speak to that. But I feel like you are wanting somebody probably to release themselves from maybe a lot of analysis that they have done, the Hanged Man. Maybe they have, maybe you kind of want them to sacrifice somebody, but I feel like this has to do with probably like somebody kind of going through an awakening here, like looking at things from all angles, right? Like figuring this out. I feel like you probably want somebody to do that. We have the magnifying glass here, right, which talks about looking very closely at something. I feel like you want a victory with this person, and I do feel like you want this person to, somebody here, to get, like, take control of their life and probably release themselves from being really stuck as well. Yeah, I feel like that's it. Could be a Piscean here. And stop the delays. The Four of Pentacles in this deck reversed is delays. OMG. You might want somebody to let somebody go, too. Sometimes this man is holding on, right? It's in the reverse. Could be let it go. And we have the Hierophant in the outcome for Taurus. Let's see what we got. And that could be you. Let's see what we have. And we have the Nine of Cups reversed. And this is you not getting your wish yet. Not yet. But I feel like you, you know, this could be, and this could simply be saying you're getting it. In your environment, you're getting it. You're getting this wish. But it's coming like prontissimo, like right away. This is coming very soon for somebody. For you, not for somebody. But my point about it is that this, when we see this in the outcome, the Hierophant, this could be you. This is what this is about. This is like sums it up. You haven't got your wish yet. Yeah, I kind of like called that out wrong, just kind of quickly when I first said that you're not getting your wish. You are getting your wish, definitely. Definitivamente, yeah. And that's a long word to say. but you're getting your wish here. I feel like you are being kind of asked to be on your best behavior, like, give this person a chance, probably to listen to them. But we're going to go to the extended and find out all about them, because we're going to have the same spread for this person, right? We are. The extended, the link is below. We're going to see their energy, what's challenging them. We're going to look at why this is all happening for them, their past energy, what's on their mind, their future. Yeah, and also their concerns, or maybe their worries, their environment, what they want, and their outcome. Thanks so much, you guys. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe. And thanks for listening, for sure. Yeah.